With so many people sheltering at home and so much uncertainty about what lies ahead, city leaders are looking for ways to buoy community spirits. The mayor of Louisville, Kentucky, thought music could help. NewsHour Weekend's Christopher Booker has more.
When Kentucky started staying home, the Louisville Orchestra conductor Teddy Abrams thought, for the first time in a long time, he would have some time.
I basically had one day where I thought, well, I guess I'm going to have a lot of time on my hands now, and which has never happened in my life. And then the mayor called.
Louisville Mayor Greg Fisher was calling Abrams in the hopes he might lead a city initiative designed to keep spirits high during these uncertain times, called Lift Up Lou.
And he said he wanted a Louisville song. He said, you figure out how to do that, but can you come up with a song that shows off the talent of our city and the diversity of our city and really has a positive message because we need it right now?
Abrams agreed and then sent off emails to members of the Louisville music community. But then he says he wasn't sure what to do next.
And then I came back home from a bike ride and I went straight to the piano and just said, I need to come up with something. And I just played the piano track pretty much straight through. I don't really know. It just must have been the right combination of ingredients outside that day, and all the musicians got that so that they could start conceiving how they'd add to it.
Abrams sent this piano track to an eclectic mix of 29 Louisville musicians, members of the orchestra, bluegrass fiddle players, a beatboxer, and rock musicians, to work on the instrumentals. Meanwhile, an equally diverse group got to work on the lyrics. Jim James of My Morning Jacket, Scott Carney of the band Wax Fang, rapper Jacory 1200 Arthur, and Will Oldham, also known as Bonnie Prince Billy.
Teddy sent some music to start with, and then Scott Carney sent a big, like, chunk of lyrics. And so I kind of distilled a few things, rephrased a few things, and then stuck in the chorus, and then Jim sang it.
Hard times come, hard times go. The hardest things to understand are the new and the unknown.
The musicians composed and recorded their parts from home, sending a file to Abrams' co-producer Ben Soli, who put together the full track. After that, they all recorded videos, which were then assembled into one complete performance.
It's only for now, it's not forever.
The sound of Louisville that you hear in there is that there's kind of an effortless an eagerness to getting together and feeding off of each other and giving to each other.
You have all sorts of different genres represented in this one 5-6 minute piece of music. You have strings provided by the Louisville Orchestra. You have Teddy Abrams, a virtuoso, playing piano. You have Jim James singing, Bonnie Prince Billy. You have myself emceeing, rapping.
What would happen if our people banded? No one left, no one stranded. Even though we feeling so abandoned, let's take a minute to make the moment candid. One time for the front line, extra daughter or son time.
How did you approach writing this verse? First of all, thinking about the theme, and then second, thinking about where it was appearing in the song.
So for me, as a Black American who descends from slavery, who is the most impacted group of this pandemic, my ancestors used to sing spirituals to reflect the sorrow, but also give hope for tomorrow. So when I write music, it's in my DNA, and I use it to reflect the times that we're going through at that moment, and this song was no different.
New start for those who've done time, but no time to play this week, no time to say this sweet. Everybody stay away 6 feet, otherwise we might lay 6 feet. We gon' need y'all to get ready. We need each other when the day comes. Lift up my city like Teddy.
And this is how the song Lift Up Louisville came to be, just a few weeks after Abrams' bike ride. The song will be released worldwide tomorrow. All proceeds from its sale will go to the city's response fund. But outside of the financial contribution, Teddy Abrams believes the song will do much more.
This is a document of this time. We are all experiencing this, obviously, simultaneously as a world. And I think we've always looked to our artists to put down the markers that we then use to understand history. And if we can represent the city in some way and say, here's how Louisville dealt with it, and here's what we were thinking at this time, then that will have been its important accomplishment.
Yeah, I'm gonna make it through. You're gonna make it too.